Guess who's back? Back again. Not Jody, and I never went anywhere, so I can't say guess who's back, because I'm always back. Well, today we got Riley's suggestion. Scammer uses religion to steal 250 Gs. That's a lot of money. And before we progress into this, I do want to say that a lot of times, actually, I've seen scammers use religion as a way to manipulate themselves into, well, the pockets of these victims. So it's interesting to see that people are... What am I saying?
So the devil will find any means, any possible means, just to destroy whatever good that the Lord is doing.
Right?
Over the past 4 years, probably somewhere along
those
the lines
are some
20,000
funky eyebrows.
He's going to do that. He's going to try to strike things up just to destroy, and he's going to be happy.
Yeah.
What's up, seekers? Welcome back to another...
What's up is Mother Nature and her angry, angry wind. I don't know what's going on there, but she's farting very badly. If so, just, yeah, be aware if you hear any wind. It's not whatever demonic things the scammer is saying. But I just wanted to pause it there and point out that if you heard that kind of, like, recording in a crime documentary... It wouldn't sound out of place. You hear that? Oh, Mother Nature is absolutely shitting bricks.
Welcome back to another episode of Scamfish presented by socialcatfish.com.
If you were to tell me that Matthew was real,
wait,
I would be ecstatic.
Who is this?
It would be my dream come true.
I want to tell you something.
Okay.
I love you.
I love you more.
Yeah,
on today's episode, we speak to a 61-year-old woman named Janette from Colorado.
Right.
She's been in contact with a man named Johnny on the dating app Christian Mingle.
So who's
the
Matthew?
Two hit it off about 4 years ago. Although Janette has never met this man in person, she is madly in love with him.
So who is the first woman with the funky eyebrows then? Who is Matthew? Because now we got Janette and Johnny.
After sending Johnny over $25,000 to help him get back home from Africa, she is now starting to have doubts that she will ever meet him in person. First, let's see what Janette has to say so we can get to the bottom of this. Real quick, guys, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Your comment and like could help stop someone from being scammed. Let's get into it.
Thank you, Catfish, as always.
Hello, Social Catfish. My name is Janette. I was divorced in 2016 after being married for almost 33 years. My ex-husband remarried within about 18 months of our divorce.
Right.
To his high school sweetheart. I guess I was feeling very lonely and kind of like just left behind.
I want to pause it there because the swiftness that the ex-husband got married. I'm 99% sure that the husband had some feelings for the high school sweetheart throughout the entire marriage, because to get married that swiftly, Taylor Swift, shake it off, Janette. Never.
What?
My youngest daughter, she suggested, you know, setting up some profiles.
Oh, it's the daughter.
Got to Christian Mingle.
Who has the funky eyebrows.
And that's where I met this man. The
right.
First message that I got from him on that app was he liked my smile.
Interesting. Riz.
One of the first things that he asked me was, why did
she's
I divorce
barely
my
smiling
husband?
In that picture, but okay.
Because he is a Christian as well, and in some circles, that's a pretty big deal.
Bit of an odd
when
question
I
to ask,
explained to him
no?
the things that happened, he apologized on behalf of men for what had happened to me.
Sounding, you know, a bit creepy, but I don't know. Maybe Janette likes that, but I find it a bit weird to just ask someone, why did you get divorced? I don't know, is that a weird question? Maybe I'm the weird one, which I am, but you get my point.
I didn't get any creepy feelings about him, and I had
okay,
my daughter
sorry.
Read all
you've
of his
answered
messages
me.
As well. and she agreed with me that this sounded like, you know, an okay person to try to connect with.
The right. First week was believable. He sounded almost too good to be true.
So you are at fault as well then.
And then once it kind of got more serious and she was talking about wanting to meet him.
Jeanette's daughter is the one who originally hooked her up with Johnny on Christian Mingle. After 4 years of phone calls and messages that Johnny has sent claiming he would show up, she has grown sick of this man and feels he is taking advantage of her mom.
I don't find any validity in anything that he's said to her.
He is Swedish, born in Nacka.
Right.
Came to the States.
Love to go Sweden, by the way, one day.
In his 30s, 51, almost 52. And he had his own
business.
A construction consultant. But that he had just landed a contract with Millennial Challenge Corporation.
Oh, we've got the classic. I've just landed a huge contract with big, big bucks. But guess what? I can't afford the basics, so you have to give it to me.
He's very intelligent. He has a great sense of humor.
Oh.
Well read.
Oh.
Very warm. He wants to know how I'm feeling and what I'm thinking. And
right.
I'm not used to that.
When Janette and Johnny first got in contact, they slowly began to talk more and more. She enjoyed talking to him so much, it became a daily routine to text him from the morning all the way through the night.
He told me his wife died and he'd been praying for the Lord to send him a woman, a wife, you know.
Right.
After he met me, he felt very confident that I was the one. It was like the second or third time that I talked to him. It was within 10 days that he told me he loved me.
Oh, 10 days and we're in love.
And of course, okay. At that point in time, I was reeling, I guess, and working through my ex-husband's marriage.
My mother is a hopeless romantic.
If that's what you want to call it, sure. Emphasis on the hopeless part here, clearly.
I definitely see a future with him. I mean, right now we're planning a future.
Oh, yeah.
We
all
have
right.
discussed the sexual aspect of our relationship. We are very strongly attracted to each other physically.
Right.
And at least from, you know, he's seen pictures of me and from the pictures that I've seen of him, we view the physical attraction and relationship as an extension of the emotional and spiritual relationship that we already have.
Sorry. Nudes. So Janette has sent nudes and received nudes. Is that what we're talking about here? Or are we just talking, you know, the face pictures? Because, you know, the man's face is there, but Johnny could also have been sent. Which would be interesting. Is it interesting though? We're going on a massive tangent right now. But has a scammer ever sent a nude? Because if they have, how do they find the right nude? Just move on.
And yeah, he talks about it a lot.
Just come outright and say it, Janette, right? You're doing dirty things in the text messages. Just, we're all adults here, all right? Some of us clearly, you know, by the... What the hell am I saying? Some of us, you know, might not act like adults, but, you know, technically I am an adult, but...
I have been celibate since before my divorce, and he has been since his wife died, and so...
Damn.
You know, he at one point in time said, I hope you don't, you know, don't be mad at me, but I don't know that I can wait, you know, because it's been so long, and I'm like, we're not kids, and... We've been around the block a time or two.
What is going
Sometimes
on right now?
Sometimes we engage in, like, if you were here right now, this is what I would be doing to you. We
Texting.
Describe the things that we would like to do together.
Right.
With each other.
What is this episode? Like,
I feel closer to him than I ever felt to my husband.
Unfortunately, things took a turn when Johnny had to travel to Liberia for work. But he needed a favor in
yep.
order to ensure he would return home.
Well, I have no
okay,
money.
So
and...
the first time he asked me for money, it was really, really early in the morning. And he basically said, here's what I need you to do. I need you to go take out, $200 or something. But I didn't have any money. You know, I didn't have a job. I was divorced. I was not even getting my full maintenance from my ex-husband. And I said, you know, I don't have any money. And he said, oh, because he was going to a third world country, he didn't want to get kidnapped.
What?
And have them extort his information from him and then, you know, drain his accounts, had all of his personal identity information put on hold or suppressed so that it wasn't accessible on the internet.
What the look, I've watched enough of these now to hear some ridiculous stories. But man is saying he needs $200 so he doesn't get kidnapped. Because that's a thing when you go to a different country for work. Your bank account is heavily scrutinized to the point you might be kidnapped for reasons I'm still trying to wrap my brain around. But not only that, actually that is only that, because I don't have another point here. So, my other point is actually, no, there is none.
But now that his card wasn't working because he did that. Sure. I'm like, you just have to call your bank. He said, no, I can't, because it's set up so that if I'm not standing there in front of them in person,
what?
They can't reactivate my account.
What bank is this?
Because there's like a fraud protection on it.
That's the best fraud protection ever, then. Unless you're eye to eye, yeah? Unless your eyeball is kissing my eyeball, we ain't giving you anything. That's a bank I would love to sign up for. I'm telling you, I'm calling them right now. But will they pick up? They would probably want me to be there.
Stop it. Get some help.
That might be one of the weirdest things I've ever done, by the way. But I meant, like, so close they can smell me.
He had left to go to Liberia. And so our conversations.
What's his job there? What is he doing?
How long his job would be there, when he planned to be coming back. He wanted to get married.
Sure.
He wanted me to look for a house.
It's been like 10 days. Point,
Janette had sent thousands of dollars to essentially fund Johnny's
life. Where
she
got this money from?
Liberia. He needed food, hotels, and water to survive. He claimed he had nothing, and Janette was willing to sacrifice her financial stability to help her future husband. But
stop it! Stop! I'm looking at the screen. Are you talking to a man named Johnny? If you are, you need to stay the hell away from him. We'll get into the weirdness that this is right now. I've remembered what I was gonna say. If you tell someone I have no money, and they say, oh, run? Because red flag. Two, if you're going somewhere for work, you don't have accommodation sorted, you got no food sorted, you run the risk of being kidnapped, I don't think I'll be turning up for this job. Sorry. See you later. It just everything about this is screaming, what is going on, Janette? Because I've heard some nonsense in these episodes. We're borderline running on batshit right now. And no one call Ozzy Osbourne because of the batshit. Because he'll, you know, bite the head off. Oh, shut up.
But she was thrown a curveball when she received an email from a woman she didn't know some shocking news about who Johnny really was.
This woman broke in and emailed me and was cussing at me and saying, stay away from him, he's mine, blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, oh my God, who are you? I don't even know this person. And she's just threatening me. And so I texted back and said, you know, who are you? You know, don't talk to me like that. But she said that she'd been in a relationship with him for years and that he was nothing but a liar and that all she wanted was to get back the money that he had stolen from her.
Wait, what?
And she said, don't do any money deals with him. You know, he's a really sweet talker. And when I called him out on it, he said, no, that's somebody that he had met through another dating website and she had been like stalking him. He didn't know how she'd gotten into how she'd gotten my email address. On how she connected with me, he wanted me to stop talking to her immediately.
Johnny wasn't actually Johnny. He claimed the reason he used another person's photos was because he felt he wasn't attractive enough for Janette. He then offered to video chat her.
I thought the guy, the first photos was more attractive, physically more attractive. What?
So he's eyes, the one on the left now.
His hair is dark brown. Matthew's hair in these newer photos is white. He's got a very athletic build. He just has an air of confidence.
Right, so you want the younger man.
And then we had video chats, and I could see him in the video, and I could hear him, and he could see me because he would respond to, you know, actions that I was doing. And I believed him.
What actions?
Those were his real pictures. They'd been stolen off of his Facebook. And I'm like, explain to me why she has the same pictures of you that I have. Explain to me why she's got your email address, you know? And he's just like,
I'm not going to talk about this anymore.
And I said, fine.
This was very odd.
See you later,
After
no?
receiving the messages from the unknown woman, Janette was blinded by love. She not only continued to speak to Matthew, she also sent him more money to help him get home.
I know that this year alone...
Shut up, Janette. If someone out of the blue messages you through email, don't know why I said messages through email, but emails you saying, stay away from this person, they're a scammer, I think you have to take their advice, because that's f***ing weird. And I don't usually use the F word, but I've done it now. So, Janette, get a grip of yourself here, because you're taking the piss. Not only have you been emailed saying this person is a scammer, they've admitted to using fake pictures, and their name is now Matthew, somehow. Three, they work a very dangerous job that borderlines them getting kidnapped for some reason. But hey, love is in the eye of the beholder, as they say. I've got four eyes, so I see through the bullshit. Oh, messed it up.
I know that this year alone, since he reconnected with me...
What?
I probably sent at least 12.
12 what?
He's not taking money from me. I'm loaning it to him. So there have been medical reasons. There was one time when he was supposed to buy an airplane ticket and fly home from Liberia.
Oh, yeah, of course.
And he didn't come, and I didn't hear from him for, I don't know, 8 days.
Oh, yeah,
and
someone else
reconnected, and he was in the hospital in Liberia. He'd gotten sick from the water and was very, very ill.
Who paid for his hospital, then? If he went to the hospital, who paid for it? Because I'm pretty sure he doesn't have insurance because he's got no money. So who paid for it?
Got him!
And I will say he did sound ill, and it sounded like he was in a hospital. But okay. He used the money that I sent for the plane ticket to pay for the hospital.
All right, fine. Just
I've sent gift cards. I've sent phones. I've sent Walmart to Walmart.
Why does he need these?
I've sent Western Union, you know, money grams. I've sent Bitcoin.
I'm sorry. You've just sent everything under the sun. Everything that can be shoved in your ass, you're pulling it out and just sending it. Gift cards, iPhones for some reason, Bitcoin I can understand, because scammers, that's what they do. But gift cards and iPhones, what's he doing? is he on the verge of being kidnapped and they're asking him for the latest iPhone? You ain't going anywhere unless you give me an Xbox Live card, you son of a bitch. You know what, Janette? You might be one of the stupidest, I'm sorry.
This summer, he needed money because he had to have eye surgery because he had glaucoma. And he was going to be going blind if he didn't get the surgery.
What?
I don't have any savings. I did take out two loans this summer for $3,000 each. So now I have loans. It comes from my paychecks.
Janette is still madly in love with Matthew.
Get a grip.
But she wants to verify his true identity before sending him
now
any more money.
I'm sad if I don't talk to him or hear from him every single day. I need interaction.
This
with
looks
him every
like
day,
a politician.
Every day. First thing in the morning, throughout the day, he messages me. I message him even while I'm at school. We talk at night when I get home, right before we go to bed. I'm sad because
when
I
does
feel
he
like
work?
He is everything I have ever or could ever desire in a partner, and he separated from me.
We still don't know his job.
And he still tells me I'm his world.
Yeah, you'd think for all that money, you are something to him.
And that gives me strength. If you were to tell me that Matthew was real, I would be ecstatic. It would be my dream come true.
If you say so.
I'm just at the point where I'm saying, I need to know, because it's either got to, it's got to end one way or the other. It's got to end with the, yes, he's but real, that... we're going to put you two together, here's the happy ending. Or it's got to end with the, no, I've been taken for a big fat ride, and I just need to know.
Well, I don't know what drew, you know, who was huffing and puffing there, but happy ending and one big fat ride. Someone is happy in either scenario.
Yeah, boy. Seekers, we had some work ahead of us.
Yeah, he's fed up.
It didn't take an expert to realize that Matthew was a scammer. The use of multiple images and requests for money were dead giveaways. Janette wanted this man to be real. Deep down, we felt she had doubts. If we could just find out who this real man in the images was,
he looks like a politician or a lawyer.
We could get her to come to terms. Matthew claimed that all of his information was removed from the internet and we would never be able to find him. With the use of our tools on our website, socialcatfish.com, that wasn't the case. We were able to locate all of his information after a couple of days of digging.
Well, yeah, where did his information go?
Wait to hear what we had found, so we immediately scheduled a call with her to give her the truth about this man she was planning to marry. Real quick, guys, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.
Of course, go and do that, but you already are.
It helps stop someone from being scared.
Probably.
Let's get into it.
Most likely. I know you're anxiously waiting for this day to finally get some answers.
Ooh, she put on little lip gloss.
At this point in time, where are you and Matthew at?
What the plan is as soon as he is able to access his Chase account, he's going to fly out here to Colorado, and we're going to get married and settle down. And so that's the plan. Just, you know, growing old together.
Do you think, you know, he's still real, or?
I hope he is, but I'm afraid to hang my heart on that.
So, I don't mean to bust you out or anything, but Chris told me that, you know, you just sent money to Matthew. We told you not to send any money.
What is wrong with these people?
You still sent it. Why did you send that money?
He's very convincing. The picture
what is wrong with
you? Has painted is what I want.
How much money did you send this time?
I sent $1,000.
Get a grip.
It just seems like he has so many problems, Janette.
I know. I agree.
That's
how
why
is
I brought
he alive?
In Virginia. They've been able to pull everything for us, and we're going to hop into it.
Do you know what is funny? Every time the scammer somehow ends up in a different country for war or whatever, that's when the problems occur. Isn't that strange that in the few days you're texting, there's no problems, but as soon as they get to a different country, their life turns to shit. It becomes the Truman Show. Anyone watch the Truman Show? I remember watching it in school. You know, that's it. If you thought there was more to that story, there isn't.
And we're gonna hop into it.
Yeah, so the first thing we looked into was your emails between you and Mary.
Unless the Truman Show, if I remember correctly, his life was like shit. So if it isn't, then I don't know what movie I'm thinking of. You know, sometimes I wonder, do I have problems?
What are you?
An idiot sandwich.
The first thing we looked into was your emails between you and Mary. I know that you were saying that Mary reached out to you and she was
who is
being a little possessive. But we looked at those emails and it seems like she was trying to warn you almost. We spoke to her as well and she did say that she just wanted to
how did
warn
she
you
find
that
Janette?
She lost a lot of money from him and she wanted to help you so that maybe you wouldn't lose money as well.
That is quite scary.
We noticed that there is a pattern in those messages.
I love her glasses.
Us with Matthew. When he's asking you for money, when does he usually ask you?
Oh, you know, right before payday, because he knows when I get paid.
It seems as if Janette was aware of Matthew's scammer patterns. We were really confused on why she kept sending him money. We had to confront her about this.
We have more information, but it seems like you know where things are kind of headed. Why do you stay? What is it with this guy?
When he's not asking for money, the conversations that we have, I don't have any man in my life that I am close to. And I feel like that's a need that I have, and he kind of fills that need. And
shush. Whilst I understand that, you know, I get the romantic side of things, you're missing it and stuff, but I don't understand why. Do you know, it would be cool if they string along the scammer to keep sweet talking them, right? Fulfill that need, that desire inside them, and just never send money, and just always say, yeah, I'll send it next week. I'll send it next week. Kind of scam the scammer, but scam them out of love, if that makes any sense. I think that would be, you know, a very devious way of... Or go outside and speak to real people.
That need, and that makes me want it to become a reality and not just virtual.
I don't know that this guy, I could tell through the chats that this guy necessarily cares for you. Reading through these chats, it doesn't seem like he has any emotion. It seems like he's almost telling you exactly what you want to hear at the exact time. I'm seeing a person that is ghosting you.
I'm sorry, but this is, it might be harsh, but this is hilarious. Not going to work tomorrow, feeling crappy. No response. I need you. No response. 6 days later. Hey, my love. Indeed, the Lord is great. There's no checking up. Saying, hey, how do you feel now? Why did you need me? Did you ever go to work afterwards? I'm choking up because I'm absolutely going to cry for Janette. Get a grip of yourself, Janette. Because if this was real and it wasn't a scammer... If these messages, you still talk to someone who talks to you like this after 6 days, they don't even check up on you, then, as I learned from someone, there's no need to put self in front of masochist. You are a masochist, Janette. You are a masochist.
It seems like he only pops up when he needs money from you. And it doesn't seem like he takes accountability for almost anything, to be honest.
Yeah.
Getting any information about who Matthew really was felt impossible. We tried to track his location, but he questioned everything after Janette let him know we were looking into him.
Of course.
We tried everything in the book to get him to click that link. He clicked on the link. He's running a VPN.
We weren't able to get Matthew's location, but we were able to hear his voice.
Can you hear me, baby?
The light, not too
I just said I'm so frustrated.
Hey, don't be frustrated, please.
It feels like everything is going wrong.
You need to relax.
Yeah, Matthew's got hella problems.
Are you still there, baby?
I said you need to relax and don't feel frustrated.
Great advice.
I want us to do right now is that I want you to take a very deep breath and be very calm. Go to the shower and
open up. Can I breathe? Your
mouth. Let the shower just, you know.
Let the shower
get
just
wet
work.
For about 5-10 minutes.
Let the shower get you wet for about 5-10 minutes. If you ever needed a pickup line to rizz someone up, there you go. Let the shower get you wet for about 5-10 minutes, because what else does a shower do? But some of the things the scammers say is actually ridiculous. But I'm glad that he said, let the shower get you wet. Because we know what their relationship is like. Janette said it with the pictures and stuff.
For about 5-10 minutes, get under the shower, okay?
How else would you get
from
wet?
From our experience, Matthew sounded like he was trying to mix up his accent to sound Swedish. But if you listen closely, you can hear the West African accent.
I don't know
accent.
What a Swedish accent sounds
so
like.
So this is what you're going to do. Let your cousin get the blanket to you.
I'm sorry. Okay, I...
Bro, what are you talking about, man?
Into your account or okay. Maybe into your whatever. But a BBC.
Hello, this is Future H coming back for the past H. Something a little bit different this. I noticed while editing this that the scammer says let your cousin give you the 1K. So not only is she sending whatever of her own money she can muster up, but she's taking money from her family to send to this guy. It's insane.
Okay, because with a BBC... With a little mistake that you do, you're going to lose the money forever.
It's not good.
And I don't want that to happen.
Of course.
I know.
Let her, let her give the money to you. And when you get it,
Bitpay.
You can pitch pay.
I have a spot on my neck. That's crazy.
Okay, so I just buy the I buy the Bitcoin with my BitPay account. Like I do.
Oh, okay. What happened to subtitles?
Very good. That is much more safer. I'm letting her, you know, BBC the money. No. Because the devil
right. Will
try to devour, try to find a way.
Okay, I'm back now. There was a fly because the mention of all this devil stuff caused a fly to somehow get in here. So I had to open the window. Let it gone. Be free. I'm out of breath from chasing the fly. So, by the way, anyone else find it quite stupid that flies somehow come in, but then once you open a window or the door, they can't get out? It's like they're banging the head right next to the window and you're like, if you just go like that, you can exit. Go be free. I am unfit.
Try to find ways, means, and everything.
This guy has to shut up now because...
Despair, just to frustrate the children of the Lord.
Stop talking about, you know...
Good motive, making things happen.
Evil.
Okay? So the devil will find any means, any possible means, just to destroy whatever good that the Lord... is doing whatsoever that the Lord is doing. He's going to do that. He's going to try to strike things up just to destroy, and he's going to be happy.
Yeah.
So be very calm. I just want to tell you something.
Okay.
I love you.
I love you more.
One more.
Yeah, because that's normal
universities.
Things. What?
Oh, I love you regardless. So do what I just asked you to do.
Yeah.
No, I'm sorry. But listen to when he says, asked you to do, the to-do bit. Listen to, by the way, Mind Panda. Amazing stress balls, by the way. Hashtag not sponsored, but Mind Panda, right? Sponsor me, please. It's good. Look, it's got like little messages. Can you see that? Love life. Okay, I cannot function, apparently. Dream big. And it smells as well. That's it. Anyway, listen to this. No, that's evil, bro. That's like if you've ever watched Ghost Adventures and they get an EVP of the spirit speaking. That's what it sounds like.
Yeah.
We want to hear what you guys think. What kind of accent do you think Matthew has?
I don't know.
Comment down below.
I don't know.
Danny, you can call your cousin. Yes,
anytime.
Okay? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes,
okay. Right, I'm assuming that's something in Swedish.
Bye.
And we hear these type of video recordings all the time from our cases, and it does sound very familiar.
Okay. And that's what I needed. I just needed somebody else to listen.
There's a cat there.
Somebody who could tell me. Okay, you're going to have to sit right here.
Oh, he's a black cat with like gray ears.
During our research process, we also looked into Matthew's images. It took us quite a while. We found tons of fake profiles using his images. We had to recruit other people in our research team, but we finally found him. The man in the images is not Matthew. His name is Michael Freeman.
Michael Freeman.
He's a retired mortgage consultant.
Right. So who was Johnny then?
So Janette, I know you have a pool of emotions going.
The loss of dreams that have been building up, you know, the past 4 years.
My goodness.
4 years of talking to this man to find out everything he told her was a
lie. Well, how long is his job? What do you mean 4 years? Didn't he say he's going for a few weeks? And what the hell, man? I don't understand. All right, there's always that one story that I react to. It comes along every few weeks. It's just, what the hell, man?
Everything he told her was a lie. Janette was very emotional in this interview. All of the images that Matthew sent to Janette were stolen from this innocent man, Michael Freeman. The original photos of Johnny were also stolen from war veteran Johnny Strickland. Both of these men have never met Janette and have nothing to do with this scam.
I think there's a guy in real life that you can actually shake his hand and actually go on real dates with him.
I'll shake his hand, sure. There's not a question for me about that.
Yeah, you're smart, beautiful. Articulate.
Oh my, that looks horrific, by the way. I'm doing this, but like, that looks horrific. Just, you know, thought I'd point that out.
Very confident that you'll find love off of the internet.
It's been amazing. I mean, I feel like you've been my friends.
We are your friends.
Yes.
I want you to know that I have felt that from the very initial contact with Chris. That's how I have felt, and I felt supported by you through this whole process.
Good.
We appreciate you so much. It was a pleasure meeting you. We're so glad you're able to move on. Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys.
Does she get the money back or?
No, Chris. I love Chris.
Okay,
no? Thanks, guys.
All right.
A few days later, she blocked plans on taking a break from online dating. Oh, what the hell is this? Hold on a second. Great news, the dream we talked about has finally come true. Not only did I get confirmation of your location, but also learned the name, location, and career of the man, whose photos you swore were the real you. Your abusive use of God's holy word and your manipulative twisting of my faith are perversions for which you will one day answer. I'm thankful my eyes have been opened and your reprehensible hold over is demolished. I'm moving into the real world where real people live and love and spend time together in person. Never contact me again. Praying you get exactly what you deserve in every way possible. What did we learn from that? We learned I can read. But also, I mean, this scammer, you sent this message. The scammer, I don't think, gives any shit, if we're being entirely honest. Because, I mean, what are you going to do? Reply, yeah, I'm sorry, but, hey, get it off your chest, hey? But it's good to know I can read. That's, you know. Otherwise, how would I do any of this stuff on YouTube? the title description if I couldn't read? That's a question for another day. It's not though, is it? Because... Oh my... I felt like my hamstring go there. My God, so unfit. As we stare at the fading away screen.
Thank you everyone for tuning...
Thank you guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed that. Definitely one of the more ridiculous stories. And one of the more ridiculous victims, in the sense that the stuff that they were listening to, the stuff that they were reading and still sending money, and I banged the desk or my laptop, but it's a joke, Janette. But hopefully you do meet someone in person and you can get your desires satisfied. Why do I make everything so dirty? I don't know. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. If you do have any other suggestions, as always, drop them in the comments down below. I'll be there. I'll be there for you like I've been there before. I think that's the lyrics. Rest in peace, Matthew Perry, by the way. A huge inspiration to my comedy. Yeah, let's not make this too sad though, but definitely, well, is my favorite character from Friends. I'll see you guys next time. Peace. And if you do want to see more, and you want to see a man fall in love, you want to see a man fall in love and try to buy a woman, go there. I wouldn't even call it falling in love. He's a disgusting piece of shit, Tony is.